Hello and welcome back to this video. So in this one we're going to be going over common mistakes I notice when it comes to lighting glass and plastics. I've noticed it countless and countless of times, both in coaching as well as in our programs, and just in general, people consistently making these mistakes when it comes to lighting glass and plastics and comes to just rendering these types of things. And I thought I would go through like all the things you need to watch out for and all the things that you need to avoid, so that when you are lighting either products or just objects in general that involve translucency, plastics, glass, any kind of see-through objects, you make sure that you avoid these things, because these are very common issues and they seem to pop up a lot. So firstly, if we pop up our renderer here and we got our little scene, so if I turn off this HDRI, this is what most people will see and what most people will start off with. It's a very common situation. The first thing is the render settings that you need to sort out in Octane. So making sure that one, this is on path tracing, and then in your path tracing settings, so if I go, let's say reset, change this to path tracing, just making sure one, your scene scale for your ray epsilon is correct, because like here you can see if your scene scale is off and it doesn't match your ray epsilon, you're going to get weird effects like this. So you want to make sure that one, here my model is modeled to scale and my scene scale and my ray epsilon is all the way down, so it matches the real world scale. And then here I like to do adaptive sampling for faster render times. But the most important thing is making sure that your specular depth is as high as possible, so that you're kind of getting all these reflections in the right places. Because here you can see if it's too low, you'll see all these dark spots. But if you want the most realistic kind of reflections and refractions and stuff, turning this up will allow to fill a lot of these dark holes, because you're getting a lot more reflections and refractions going in there. And the high up you go, the more you'll see like these dark spots kind of start to remove, and that's how you kind of get the most realistic. So around between 25 and 50 is usually the best option for me, but you can kind of just keep going up until you see as many of the dark spots remove, until most of them are gone. And then that's essentially the main things that you want to watch out for. So I like to turn this up and then the next thing is, so here is where usually people start throwing in area lights and stuff like that, and the problem is they're lighting from a middle gray. I like to light from a all blacks section. Otherwise, if you're lighting from a middle gray, you'll kind of get this washed out middle gray tone to your renders, just because the blacks aren't really deep black, they're a middle gray, and that removes a lot of the contrast, makes your renders look flat. So you want to make sure that you're lighting from a black, and then you can start throwing in your area lights and HDRs and stuff like that. So here's usually where people pop in an HDRI, and this is all fine. And then let's say they want their backgrounds to be a solid color. So here, if we go color, and we say visible, and we just want our background to be white. Here is the issue, and I see this a lot as well, where their renders look like this. And the big problem is they don't change their refractions to match the background of their environment. So you want to make sure that the refractions match. So you want to tick this on so that you can at least see through the products. Otherwise, you're going to get like weird looking renders like this. This is so, so common, you can't believe. And you always want to make sure that you can see through correctly. This mixed with your specular depth being high enough and not like this, or even like this, will help you see through correctly. And now you can see we're starting to get more realistic reflections and refractions. So another common thing is making sure, just in case I forget, your object and the glass piece here has thickness. You want to make sure that this thing isn't just one flat plane. It needs to be an object with thickness, if you want to get the most realistic and best look. Otherwise, you'll get something that looks like glass, something that looks like a bubble, as opposed to something that looks as like thick glass. Then the other things are to do with the material itself. So with the actual material, let's say we name this glass. If you want it to be 100% translucent, you want to make sure that this is at 100%. Otherwise, it's going to get that middle gray tone. And then you also want to make sure that your index matches the value of whatever object it is. Because here, if you look at the reflections and the refractions, and then let's say we change this index to a glass index, which is around 1.5, you'll see that the reflections and refractions change. And this changes as you go up and as you go down. And if you want it to look more like glass as opposed to water, you want to make sure that this matches your index of refraction. So those are the most common things. You kind of want to go through this like a checklist to making sure that your lighting and stuff, when it comes to, and your sort of rendering in general, when it comes to plastics and glasses and stuff, you want to go through this checklist and make sure that you're watching out for all these things, because all of these things are, whenever I see a glass render, at least one of these things I notice. And especially, yeah, just in general, when I look through, let's say, our programs and people posting in our groups, in coaching, and just online, when I look at other people's work, I see this happening all over the place. So I felt like this was really important to kind of nip in the bud, so that people watch out for these things and make sure that they watching out for these things, correcting them before the mistakes kind of happen and stuff. So yeah, again, if you want to check out your there's a free training in the link in the description below. There's a link for mastering your 3D in 2021, getting the best out of it. On our success page, we've added some free videos from our program, as well as a couple customer interviews, as well as progress from other people in the program, so you can see even more in terms of like what goes in our program. So if you want to check that out, there's a free video in the description below. Otherwise, I hope you enjoyed the video. Watch out for these things. Go look at your work. Make sure that you're not making these mistakes. And then you should see that any renders to do with glass and transparency and plastics and stuff like that, you should see some big improvements, because these are things that I see all the time. So hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you on the next one.